Hi, you guys. It's Koya Webb, and I'm here with Whitney, Eco Vegan Gal.
Hi.
And she is on the show today to tell us a little bit about holistic makeup. I've been really wanting to know how I can take my makeup game to the next level, eco-friendly. Mm-hmm. And so I just wanted to ask her about the products she used because she studied like the best of the best, and I need to get the tips from the best.
Well, thank you. I'm very flattered. I've had a lot of trial and error over the years with different natural makeup, and sometimes
they don't last.
Sometimes it doesn't last. Yeah. Sometimes it doesn't look good. But more and more options are coming out now. So it's really exciting, actually. Mm. I mean, I can't keep up with all the eco-friendly vegan makeup lines now. It's incredible.
Wow.
But I have my own little routine, whether I'm just doing it to go out, whether I'm going out a night on the town or go out, you know, just for lunch or something, or whether I'm going to be on camera, it kind of shifts around.
Mm-hmm.
So I want to show you the brands today that are kind of like my basics.
Yeah, we want to see your
all the
best.
Time.
Yes. Your favorite.
My routine includes what I'm going to show you today.
Okay.
So I always start off with Raw Skinceuticals.
Mm.
And this is a super basic mineral-based makeup here. It's a foundation. Okay. I don't know if they have other products aside from these foundations. It's kind of like a BB cream, which means that it's kind of giving you the coverage. Yep, absolutely. And it has an SPF in it, so it's also protecting you from the skin.
That's
from
really
the sun
important
as well. Let's see, it has the UVA and the UVB protection.
That might not
and
be my color.
It's got antioxidants in it and vitamin C.
You can't even see
right?
it.
Right? And it's got
awesome.
All different shades, so no matter what your skin tone is like, you can try that out. And I just love it. I've been using them for over two years.
This is your this is the main thing you wear on your face.
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
Awesome. Because what I found when I've tried natural products, I've found that it looks very cakey, or you can like it's not as you know, you don't have as much coverage and things like this. But this is not like that.
No. You can see it's almost like a moisturizer, but it,
it's
got
really
that liked
subtle
it. Look,
yeah,
but still gives you coverage.
It's very matte as well.
Yes.
Yeah. Not shiny.
Yes.
I need that because I get shiny in the T zone. And it's like not shooting. It's like I'm probably shiny now, but you know, maybe I put some on my nose. There we go.
No, it works really well. So you can use this all the time because it's also good for your skin.
Mm-hmm.
That's the key with the natural makeup is that a lot of people break out when they use chemical-based makeup. So when you're using natural makeup that has things like vitamin C in it, it's actually food for your skin. So it's good. You're not going to get as many breakouts unless you have super sensitive skin. In that case, you might need to look for something very specific, but as far as I know, this should work for most skin types.
You gotta try it out.
Then I go into my little routine with my bronzer, my blush, and my eyeshadows and all that.
I think I put on I put on a base, and then I take my lip liner, and I think I put on my lips, my cheeks, my eye. I know that's so terrible, but you tell
the same,
us. Like,
the same product.
The same product.
I actually think that's great. Why not?
It's resourceful, right?
Yeah.
But I want to know, I want more professional. Like, I want some eyeshadow that's really nice. Like, I'm very basic.
Yeah.
I have kind of like a fitness model repertoire. You know, it's just kind of like, you know, one or two products. You got to go work out. It's no big deal. But when I go out for a night, I like to have some shine, some glitz.
Yes,
you know,
exactly. So. Well, for you, then, I would say Pacifica is a really great choice. It's natural mineral-based makeup, and it's really available like almost anywhere. Almost every natural store, including Whole Foods, carry it. This one, as you'll see, has been really worn.
Oh, nice! It's sparkly,
right?
So very shimmery.
This one's cool, Koya, because it has a bronzer, a blush, and then it has colors that you can use on your eyes. And then these at the top are highlighters, which you can use in different parts of your face.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just got a lot of variety. So.
And you got this from Whole Foods?
Yeah, yeah.
I love this because it has like a shimmery gold, a shimmery rose. It has a shimmery brown, a shimmery green. I love these colors.
Yeah,
you like have all my favorite colors.
They're nice
here.
And basic, right?
Okay,
they're kind of earthy toned, and that's the other thing. And Pacifica also has this one, which is just eyeshadows.
Okay.
These are really light. So I use this when I'm kind of getting a little bit more dressy, but this is great for daily wear because it's very subtle. It just puts a little hint of a color on your eyes. So I use both of these back and forth, actually.
Awesome. I love this.
And
I
they also make great eyeliner, too. So different colors, brown, black, silver.
Now, is it waterproof or is like waterproof like not good? Like there's different schools of thought on that one. Like
you know, I don't know because for me, maybe if you're sweating a lot, right?
Mm-hmm, but sometimes I sweat a lot.
I don't.
My face.
I don't put makeup to go to yoga, but sometimes I'm still wearing makeup when I'm in yoga.
Right.
And I usually find that my makeup lasts throughout. Mm-hmm. You know,
do you mind? I'm gonna,
a good part of it.
I'm just using it like I'm in the
Why
store.
Not?
It's like a tester. I won't use it that much because that's important. Oh, no, this doesn't run as much.
No.
One way you can test the liner to see if it's good, make a line on your skin and rub it. It's
oh.
as this one does. It doesn't smudge. Now,
yes.
if you want a smudge, get a smudge. But I like for my line to stay.
Yes.
So I make it and I rub it. And as you can see,
it's
not like it's still
yeah.
there. It's not running all over the place
mm-hmm.
because, you know, see it and someone wake up and you have all this smudge all over your eyes. And I think that actually ages you.
Yeah.
Even if it's natural, like when you have makeup residue like on your eyes, it actually ages your eyes.
Oh,
so
yeah.
make sure that you take your makeup off at night and use a natural brand.
It's a good balance. I'll tell you at the end what one of the things I use to take off my makeup
because
oftentimes with chemical-based makeup, it takes forever to take it
yeah.
off, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then you're putting more chemicals on your face just to take it off.
Right.
So I like the balance of makeup that'll wear for a few hours at least, but it'll also come off at the end of the night
mm-hmm.
pretty easily. So we'll talk about that too. Pacifica also has one of my favorite products, which is these
Limp Biscuit.
Lip tints.
Don't have limp lips.
I know. So this lip tint
uh-huh.
is really sweet because it's like a combination between a lipstick and a chapstick. And so it's got
good.
A little bit of color on it, and it also has some things to keep you really
nice.
Moisturized in there. And I love it.
You
tastes
just twist
amazing.
It,
mm-hmm.
and I won't take it all
They
way.
Have a few different shades, and so these are great for if you want something very subtle on your lips, or if you just want a chapstick with a little bit of color.
This is like vanilla hibiscus.
Mm-hmm.
That's nice.
It tastes amazing.
I like vanilla anything.
Me too.
Right? If it's got a vanilla in it, give me
yep.
some of that.
Yes.
I love
Agreed.
That. Awesome.
Agreed.
Yes, all the goodies. What else
I
do you
know.
Have?
Well,
what
then for other lipsticks, when I want something that's a little bit bolder, a little
mm-hmm.
prettier, classier, there's two lines that I really like. One is Imani. And these are organic lip shine.
I like this one.
Isn't that
Look at
fun?
This one. It's so sparkly.
It's very sparkly.
Okay.
Yeah.
I have to try this one.
Yeah.
Imani.
That one is so cool.
Okay.
And it kind of looks like what you're
I'm
wearing.
Just dipping it all her
this
makeup.
This one too. This is my. Oops. This one has a piece of hair.
It's her hair, so it doesn't matter. No, I'm not using
yeah,
that.
Yeah. Exactly.
But
no.
this is shiny. Oh my God. I have to get some of this.
Yeah.
This is like my favorite.
They come in all different great colors.
Organic lip shine.
Yes.
I like
the other
it.
Brand I really like is Glam Natural, and
mm-hmm.
they have really great shades. So
I'm into
these,
sparkly now.
Yeah,
like sparkly
well, then
is
go
really
for that
in.
One.
I love this. Is this one sparkly? This one's kind of sparkly too, but not really when you put it
yeah,
on.
Yeah, not really.
Not
really. As much as that one.
So Emma is your favorite.
Imani.
Imani
yep.
is your favorite.
Yeah, I would say
okay.
I go back and forth between Glam Natural and Imani.
I wonder how this Enema.
I mean,
don't call
bad.
It that. Don't call it that.
Someone had a makeup like Enema.
That'd be terrible. Imani.
Yeah, Imani.
Okay.
No, it's great. It tastes great. It looks great.
Awesome.
Mascara.
Oh,
it's
God.
It's very important, too. And it is hard to find.
It is hard to find,
find
a good
natural
mascara. Oh.
Mascara, first of all.
Mm-hmm.
But then mascara that doesn't have beeswax in it if you're vegan. I mean, mascara always is challenging.
Yeah.
And I'm not 100% sure that this is one of the cleanest, but because of most of their line, I feel like it's a cleaner option.
Okay.
I think they're still developing a mascara that is natural and effective. But this is the one I use most days. I've never had an allergic reaction to it.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't bother my eyes. I know it's at least
oh, wow.
mostly natural. And this is from Glam Natural
I like
as well.
Smelling everything. Glam
Does it smell
Natural.
Good?
Yeah,
I've
I
never
mean,
smelled my
I mean, if it smells like really strong, I'm usually
yeah.
not into it. I'm very sensitive. But
yeah.
one, I love this brush.
Yep,
like, look at that
brush.
Thick brush.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man.
It goes
you have
on,
a lot of goodies
it
here.
It stays on really well. It's not going to, like, you know, all these mascaras out there that, like, say they're going to do all this stuff for your eyelashes.
Right.
Like, this is just mascara, but it does the job and it's mostly
and
natural.
You have to play with your mascara because you want to test it. You see me taking
mm-hmm.
it on and off because some of them, they don't have a good, what do you call it, declumper.
Oh,
but basically
yeah.
you take it out and it has gobs of
yes.
makeup on the brush and you put it on and it's all clumpy.
Yeah,
so you have to make sure when you take it in and out, it actually cleans the brush so
yep.
that you get a nice sweep. And
yep.
I don't know much about makeup, but I know that.
Okay. Yeah, it's the practical stuff, right?
Yeah, exactly. This is good. Yeah. Glam Natural. Mm-hmm. I think Glam Natural, the Imani, I definitely, and the Pacifica, I definitely have to.
Oh, great.
I want to try those.
And then for your nails?
Nails, yes.
So
I love nails.
Nail polish can be really toxic.
Scotch.
In so many ways. And there's kind of like three different types of nail polishes.
I need to do my nails.
There's the standard, really toxic nail polishes. There's the semi-natural nail polishes, and then the water-based nail polish that I brought today is Scotch Naturals, and it is like really clean. You can barely smell it, which
smell
is
test.
Cool. That, you know, the smell test says a lot. It
smells like crayons.
Fumes. Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, crayons are like a, you know, that water-based paint. We would
exactly.
We're painting the color. That's exactly what it smells like.
Yep.
Wow.
Yeah,
this
it's
is
really
a nice,
nice
color.
I love that
what
color.
What is this
sexy.
Color? Bitter and Twisted. Bitter and Twisted.
They have all the different shades
mm-hmm.
that you want. You
like
just have to go through a different routine with this because it chips more easily than a lot of nail polishes. So you have to really be mindful about how you put this on. And they have mm-hmm. instructions on their
Maybe
website.
Maybe a top coat.
Yep, they have top
like
coats
that.
And base coats, and they want you to like buff
awesome.
Your nails and all
okay.
of that. But it's I just love it because it's so natural.
It's pretty.
And I want all of you to live long lives. And if you're
long and natural.
Inhaling all of these chemicals from your nail polish, not good.
No.
It can cause all sorts of major issues.
Yeah, and that's what's important to me, and that's why I'm having Eco Vegan Gal on, is because the more you try, you don't have to get every product here, but the more you add one thing at a time to your daily regime,
yes.
the more you'll feel better. Some people get headaches because of the products they're using
exactly.
on their hair and on their nails and things like that. So take something that you really like from what we share with you and maybe just try it out.
Yeah.
Just give it a try.
Or try a different brand that's similar. You're going to find something that works
mm-hmm.
well for
yeah.
you and others that don't. It's just kind
Absolutely.
Of a starting
point.
So one last thing for your beauty routine is how to take off your makeup, right?
Mm-hmm. Important.
I found that a lot of natural face washes don't take it off.
Mm.
Have you ever done that where you wash your face and then you like put your towel and like some of your makeup comes off in your towel and you're like,
yeah.
I just washed my face.
Absolutely.
Why is this on the
I
towel?
Use oil. Do you ever use oil
That's
on your
what
face?
This is.
Oh, cool.
So this is an oil. Oil is actually phenomenal for getting off makeup. And I'll often combine it with a face wash. And this is one I've been trying on. It's called Bare Face Cleansing Oil from Julep. And it's rosehip seed oil.
Ooh.
And it's really thick, and it's just...
It smells great.
It smells really good.
Oh, my goodness.
And you put that on, and I like to let it sit, and then I rub it off, and then I wash my face. So you could actually use coconut oil.
Mm-hmm.
You can use a lot of different olive oil.
I like
even.
The fragrance, though. This
that
is really,
really
pretty.
Yep.
It seems like you can even put it in your hair. Have you ever tried it in your
Probably
hair?
Probably could, yeah.
I'm all about oil on the hair,
yes.
and this smells amazing.
Yep. And it's nice, because, you know... It depends what level you want to go in.
Mm-hmm.
Not everybody is comfortable taking a jar of coconut oil into the bathroom and using it to take off their makeup.
It's kind of messy.
Yeah.
I do it, but it's kind of messy. I would rather, especially when you're traveling, you don't want a big jar of coconut. I would love to have something really nice
yes,
like this.
Exactly.
This is really great.
Yep.
If I'm addicted to her stash.
Okay, no, it's
nice.
So nice. You just want to make sure that from beginning to end, you're taking care of your skin.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people don't know this or don't think about it in this way, but your skin is your largest organ.
Mm-hmm.
So we're doing
Absolutely.
so much for our internal organs, but we also want to take care of our external organ, right? So whatever you put on your skin, on your face, wherever it is in your body, it's coming into your body.
Yeah, and you want to be able to eat it. I mean, that's the biggest thing that
really?
I learned. Like, the health coaches that I study and inspire me and that I follow, they're like, if you can't eat it, you don't want to put it on your
no.
skin. You know,
no,
you should be able like to lick your hand and it's
and
good.
Recognize the ingredients
mm-hmm.
and really
be able to pronounce
yes,
the ingredients.
Yes, absolutely.
So important.
Yep. So empowering yourself to just try new things and to know, you know, you feel confident because you look beautiful and you feel good. You're not having allergic reactions to things or having health problems because of what you're putting on your body.
And it's beneficial for the planet.
Exactly.
That's what I love.
Exactly.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much,
yes.
Eco Vegan Gal, for coming and joining me on my channel.
My pleasure.
And if you want to hear more about what she has to offer, you can find her on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat. Snapchat. follow this girl. She's amazing. She has all kind of eco-friendly vegan tips. I adore her. Check her out on all the social media channels, Eco Vegan Gal. And if you have any questions or comments, or you even want to share your favorite natural products, please leave it in the comments below.
We want to hear what you use.
Yes, we want to hear about it.
What are your favorite natural, vegan, cruelty-free products?
I need to know. I need to really stock my purse with all these great, amazing products. Thank you so much for watching, and be sure you like this video, leave a comment.
Subscribe
to my channel, and I'll see you next time.
Bye.